Welcome to the expert group. In the previous lecture, we discussed the PN junctions and the type of doping and the doping material, how the N-type and P-type materials are made by different types of doping of pentavalent and the trivalent impurities. Today, we'll discuss the diode testing with using digital multimeters. Digital multimeter provide the facility to test the serviceability of the diode, and also if the marking of cathode or anode on the diode has omitted or removed, and we are unable to detect which is the cathode of the diode and which is the anode of the diode, then we can use the digital multimeter to know the anode and cathode of the diode. The diode can be tested by using digital multimeters by using both the ways, as the reverse bias and the forward bias. We use the red or positive terminal to put on the anode of the diode, and the black or negative terminal on the cathode of the diode, that would be in the forward bias, and also we will check it by the reverse bias. When it would be in forward bias, I have already mentioned that for positive lead or red lead to the anode, or common or black lead to the cathode, it would be in the forward bias. And for reverse bias, the positive lead would be connected to the cathode and the common or black lead to the anode. Here a point to be noted that if we are using a previous or analog voltage or ohm meter to check it, here the difference is that the positive or red lead that is in the digital multimeter, in the analog meters it is the black lead. The black lead would be the positive and red lead would be the negative. This point must be considered when using the previous or old analog voltage or ohm meters. In the case of digital multimeter, we'll use the positive or red lead to the anode and the black lead to the cathode for the forward bias. If we find that the diode is serviceable, then what are the indications on the digital multimeter that the diode is serviceable? When we have connected it to forward bias, the resistance will be very low, in the range of about 1 to 10 kilo ohm, and the voltage, if we check the voltage drop, that would be in the range of 0.3 for germanium and 0.7 to 8 or 9 voltage, dependent on the diode, would be for the silicon. And if we connected it in the reverse bias, then if the diode is serviceable, it would present a very high resistance, and it on the screen the overload would be showed. And here another indication is also that the digital multimeter would for forward bias would create a short beep. A brief beep would be indicated that would indicate that the in forward bias the diode is serviceable. And if the diode is unserviceable, then what are the circumstances or what are the indications that would be presented by the digital multimeter? If the diode is open and we have connected it in forward bias, in normal condition the resistance is very low, but for open circuit, the in forward bias, the resistance would be presented by the diode would be very high. And if we have connected it reverse bias, it also again would be very high resistance. But if the short diode has shorted, then forward bias would be very low, and for reverse bias also the resistance would be very low. Here for forward bias, the difference is that normally For serviceable diode, the forward for forward bias, the resistance is also low. And what would be the difference that a short diode has a short circuited? The beep indication for digital multimeter for a serviceable diode was a very brief beep. But when you find that the diode is shorted, then the multimeter would create a long beep. Until we have connected the terminals, it would create a beep, a long beep. So we have today we have discussed the testing of the diodes. For more videos, subscribe our channel, and thank you very much.